Ja, kent u dat fenomeen dat je wel de stem misschien kent, maar niet meteen de man die erbij hoort? Nou, dat had ik bij Wake Me Up. Dat nummer is op YouTube meer dan 300 miljoen keer beluisterd. En de man achter die stem is Alu Black. Thank you for coming here in our studio in Amsterdam. Thank is it your you. First time in the Netherlands?
No, I've been back and forth to the Netherlands for the past 10 years.
10 years in Paradiso, you've been performing
yes,
over there?
Yes, I have actually. Yeah, definitely.
Can you describe to me what happened after your big hit, Wake Me Up with Avicii?
Well, after the hit, a lot of attention came my way because people were asking, well, who's singing this song and what other songs does he have? So people started making the connection with I Need a Dollar, going back and finding out. And then with my new song, The Man, they were ready for some new music.
Yeah. Well, the lyrics you wrote about Wake Me Up, you wrote them in the airplane, as I understand.
Yes, I did.
Something came in. And if you read the first lines, feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. Mm-hmm. What was the darkness you were feeling?
Well, you know, the idea is life in general. It seems like when you're young, you're just discovering things and learning things for the first time. And sometimes you don't know exactly where you're going. And it's almost like you're feeling your way through the darkness, learning what your boundaries are, and where you can step and where you can move. And to me, that's what I was talking about, that journey through life, still learning, sometimes falling, sometimes stumbling, but just finding your way.
And did you already had Avicii in your mind when you made those lines up?
No, I had IWC in my mind. I was coming home from watch convention in Geneva.
Okay, you went there.
And I was being treated very well because they're a wonderful brand, and they put me in first class, and I was thinking, my life is a dream. This is literally unexpected and unbelievable. Wake me up when it's all over.
Did you perform there?
Sometimes I do. I don't think I performed there. I was just...
Now, you know why? Because I went to the convention
did
as well.
You?
Yes, I did. And when I was there, you know who I saw there? Really, for truth.
Who?
Chic.
You saw Chic?
Chic performed at the IWC convention where you were. Yes.
Maybe I left too early.
Yeah, I saw that.
But I ended up meeting up with Nile Rodgers in the studio with Avicii.
So you're coming from that dream because it is a dream.
Coming from the dream.
I know what you mean because beautiful people, great stuff,
of
beautiful
course.
Watches, whatever. Mm-hmm. And then you're in the plane and you come up with the song.
Yeah.
Could you let me hear a part of the song, please?
The first part that I wrote. The first part I wrote was...
Wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older.
And then I had other lyrics in my phone. I didn't know what they meant or where they would go.
Yeah.
But when I got to the studio, I said, okay, I'll put this together.
All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost.
So once I put those together, and everybody in the... Mike Einziger was playing the guitar, and Avicii was there, and they said, this sounds great. I said, okay, good. Now I'll start writing the rest of the song. And that's when I came with...
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start.
It's almost like I was just talking to them about my life.
But the way you sing is like you're talking as well, because it's really like nice, relaxed. Is that you the way you always sing?
No, it's not the way I always sang. And it took me a long time to figure out what was the best way for me to sing. And I tried everything from salsa, dancehall, hip-hop, R&B, folk music. And eventually I realized it's a folk soul that's the best way to use my voice.
So how did you come up with the folk soul? Because it's been a journey, though.
It came when I released Good Things and I Need a Dollar. That's when I realized, okay, this is how it sounds good for my voice. This is what people appreciate to hear from me, and this is what makes me feel comfortable.
Because in some texts you're being described as a rapper, but you're not a rapper.
Well, for 10 years I was.
But not anymore.
Depends what day of the week.
But do you still perform as a rapper? Do you still make...
You know, I don't do it regularly, but I still do it because it's part of my history, it's where I come from, and it's really what helped me learn to write lyrics.
But why did you leave that part then?
I left it because it was very narrow in terms of the way that I could express emotion. Hip-hop doesn't allow for certain kinds of ideas and certain kinds of feelings, and I wanted to be able to affect people with melody. melody is so important. Sometimes you can affect somebody to laugh or cry or be angry or smile just from the melody alone. And you don't really have that with rap lyrics. You don't have melody. You have just words. So I wanted to use words and melody.
As I understand, your father asked you to your new album to be more happier.
Yes.
Is this album more happier?
It's definitely a happier album.
Lift your spirit?
Absolutely.
In what way?
Well, the songs that I'm writing, that I wrote for the album, definitely are happier in tone and in content. So the music is making me happy and the lyrics are making me happy.
You're making me happy with your songs.
Right on.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Allo Black. Thank you.
Thank you.
Black and tan.